What time is my creatives? That's right, it's photo hacking time, and it's your host, Charlotte Salcedo. And today I'm going to be teaching you how I organize my fonts. So we had some questions, and I'm continuously getting questions on the subject, so I wanted to do a video, and I'm just gonna read a couple of the questions that have been asked. Oh, I too would like more instructions on the setup. Do you remove all the fonts and or the hard drive and move them into a different removable drive? Or does the removable drive need to be continuously connected? Thank you. And the next comment here is, thank you very much. This tool is amazing. I don't find the video to organize all the fonts though, and I need help. Thank you. So I do want to get into and answer these questions, but this video has to be in a two-part video because MainType Professional Edition has updated their software to address this issue, because before I was creating my own folders and setting it up outside of the font software, but now it allows you to do it internally. So I'm going to show you how I did it before they updated the software, and then I'm going to go over the updates and the MainType Professional Edition software. So here we go. Okay, so notice in this software, we have the font software here, the root folder, which is also in the external drive here, fonts. So you can see that's being called back to the actual font manager because I have it set up like that. And I showed you how to do that in the last video. So, and we're gonna go over that again in the updated video. There's gonna be two parts to this video. But I wanted to answer your question specifically. You asked me, do I transfer all of the fonts to the external hard drive? Do I have to have my computer continuously on? Well, in order to explain that, I'm going to show you a picture of my setup. So basically, these are four external hard drives that I have hooked up to my Asus monitor. I have a special ProArt monitor, which is basically a what you see is what you print type monitor. And these are basically pre-calibrated monitors that are specifically for graphic designers. If you don't have one of these, then you're probably getting all the colors wrong for your clients. Your clients are probably complaining. Unless you have a Mac computer, you definitely need one of these for the PC. I don't see how any graphic designer could survive without one. But it is how I have this setup. So these external hard drives are hooked up to this monitor, and this monitor is a beast because it has four external USB ports additionally to the other features that it has with it becoming pre-calibrated. I don't know if you know, but to calibrate your monitor, your existing monitor, you need a device called a spider, and it's really expensive, and it still doesn't do a good a job as having this monitor. So I highly recommend watching my previous video on the stuff that I purchased and why I have the stuff that I have. So anyways, now you're probably looking at this and this looks probably kind of ghetto, but here's the thing. I did have G Suite, which was unlimited storage for $12.99 a month. Storage hasn't gotten cheaper because it's been more accessible. It's actually gotten more expensive and more hackable. So I find that putting myself on, like putting all of my content, you know, like, because this is my livelihood, if I lose the stuff on my hard drives, then I basically lose my business. So in trusting somebody like Google, who can't complete a project to save their life, they're always starting projects, ending projects. I mean, really, what has Google ever kept that's been permanent? I mean, they're always changing their software, they're always changing things, and that to me is volatile for my business. And so therefore, I have moved away from using external companies as the end all be all to my storage problems. I don't rely on them. I basically have these external drives, and there is a better way to set this up, and I'm about to show you. But the reason why I have it this way is because it's the most affordable and economical for me now. Each of these hard drives are about 5 terabytes each, and they cost me $100 on sale. Sometimes they cost me $79, but I put dates on them. And then once they expire, I give them a year and I expire them and I replace them one by one. And so it's a lot easier for me to replace these external hard drives, and I don't erase the data on them. I put them in a shoebox in a stored dried area that has like a humidifier in there, like in my closet. So I basically do not delete that data. I keep it as a backup, so in case something happens. I also have, I have 4 internal hard drives on my custom built computer where I have my fonts, I have my scratch disk, and I have an additional backup here, backup don't touch. And I have a scratch disk solely dedicated to Photoshop. And I also have the font stored there. And then I also have, I basically zipped all my fonts. I do this like every couple of months. I re-zip up my fonts and then I put them on the cloud storage. So I have multiple ways where I back up my fonts, because this is a collection of over, I don't know, 20 years. And to lose that kind of content of money that I've spent over time, I swear to God, I've spent over 50 grand on fonts, probably more than that. So to lose that type of investment is just asinine at this point, if I don't do something to like really, protect it. So that is how I have it. Now, going back to the picture, if you see these wires here, every time my monitor turns off, like say for instance, I have it set up on a sleeper. So if I walk away from my desk, my computer will fall asleep. And that's when you see the screensaver pop up. You will see that these lights will go out on these. So I have set it up to where when my monitor goes to sleep, my external hard drives go to sleep. Because if you have it set up any other way, these external hard drives, if you're working like I do and you have your computer on 24/7 and you have your external hard drives on 24/7, they're going 24/7 and they're going to break down a lot quicker. So by setting them up this way, setting them up to the monitor and letting them go to sleep at the same time. Now, if I turn off my left, because all of these hard drives are hooked up to my left monitor, which my left monitor, I don't use as my main monitor, I use my right monitor. So if I'm not using my left monitor, I can just turn off my monitor and those hard drives will go to sleep. Anytime that you have that monitor off or your computer's asleep, you don't have access to those fonts, okay? So it's good and it's bad because I'm preserving the actual drives there, and while I'm not using them, they're not, you know, exuminating a lot of heat power, because when you're when you're actively using it, it does, and it can overheat. So to answer your question, the way that I have it set up, it only gets turned on when I'm actually using the computer, which is pretty cool. And I didn't have it always set up like that before though. My computer had actually failed on me, and I came out and I called the computer doctors of Tampa Bay, and they came out to my house, and I had asked them, I have all these USB ports on my monitor, but they're not working. And he showed me that there is a specific device that you have to hook up from the monitor to the computer to get the USB ports on the side to work. And I'm like, duh, why didn't I know that? And sometimes you just need a computer genius to help you out. So if you have a local computer doctor, it may be a little bit expensive to get this type of person in your house to help you out, but the knowledge you gain from it and the less headaches that you have, it just makes your workflows such a smoother process. I mean, we want to be cheap and we want to like not have to pay somebody to do something, but sometimes in the long run, it's more beneficial to hire an expert because of what we're dealing with is so expensive, and the consequences of not doing so is a lot worse than not hiring somebody. And whatever you do, don't you ever take your computer to Best Buy. You will fucking regret it. Now, speaking of how I have my funds set up, I have them set up in a way that I can remember and in a way that works for me. Now, I've named my fonts different things in the way that I use them. Like a lot of times I will look for ampersands and, you know, specifically just ampersands. Sometimes I look for Arabic fonts if I have like Arabic themed posters that I want to do. Army, Art Deco, babies and kids. These are things that I can easily remember, you know? Boho, Native American, brush fonts, burn book fonts, like like just different things, like circus fonts, church, Christian fonts, things. I've categorized them into just different things. Like, you probably wouldn't have a fancy as fuck category, but I find these fonts to be fancy as fuck, and that's how I remember them. They're like super fucking like bougie fonts that are just like way out there. They're like super fucking fancy. So if I'm looking for something that I'm gonna design a project that's like so super fancy, I just drag and drop those fonts in here when I go font hunting. And font hunting is the some people go hunting for rabbits. I go font hunting. My favorite place to go font hunting is on Creative Market. And I like to look for the font bundles versus just paying for individual fonts. So under the font hunting, you will find that before you buy individual fonts, if you look on here, you will find that most of these people have all of their fonts grouped into just like one bundle for the price of just one font. So this is what I love to do. I love to come in here and go font hunting. And then there are certain people who I basically have as a name basis. Nikki Latz, well, I guess maybe I spelled her name wrong. I don't know. But Nikki Latz is like the $1 million font maker. And she made over $1 million making fonts, and her fonts are just like so great. And this chick's fonts are some of my favorites. Super nice stuff. Oh my God, I just love her fonts. And I don't know how she got like a half star here. These fonts are so gorgeous. This is my favorite font designer, probably more than Nikki Latz, because it's just so creative. I just love her stuff. And you get 188 fonts. For, well, it's not going to show you the price here, but $39. And I think when I bought these, they were $29. But it's just amazing, all the fonts that you get. And then, like, I store these fonts in, like, group bundles. Like, I have this person's name in a folder because I specifically love this particular artist font so much. They're by a name basis with me, Nikki Latz. Well, not all fonts are like that. Not all fonts are created equal. Sometimes you'll buy fonts off of here and they're not lined up right. They're just like really shitty, but you know what I mean? So here goes Nikki Latz folder. And you can see here that I have some fonts in here that I bought through bundles, her Fontholics color bundles, and a lot of the other bundles here, and I just stick them in here. So anytime that you open the font software, like say for instance, if you added a font to this alien folder, let's just go to DaFont. Let me go to DaFont so I can show you what I mean. All right, so I'm gonna look for alien fonts. Okay, so let's just say that you like these Weendings and you download this. Okay, so I'm just gonna extract this alien fund. It's called Alienator. All right, and so I would just drag this font into this folder. And so when I go font shopping or font hunting, whatever you want to call it, I typically tend to basically, when I organize my fonts, I just put them in their respective folders to keep them organized. And this helps me when I'm looking for a project. It helps me know, like, if I'm doing a poster about aliens or if I'm doing something about aliens, I want to look for alien fonts. This is really, really quick. You know what I'm saying? So if you're looking for fonts for a tattoo shop, okay? So most of these folders didn't get created like in the beginning. These folders got created because I had a project that I had to do and I needed certain fonts. Like, for example, I had a lemonade project recently where I created a whole entire website based off of a summer lemonade-y theme. And so I went looking for fonts that spoke to me, that were like lemonade. You know what I mean? That reminded me of summer or lemon type fonts that were fun and whatever. And so I put them in there. Like if you're working on a project with markers and pens, like you want to give that vibe that you're drawing or something like that. You know, if you have a Mexican theme, like we just had Cinco de Mayo, I mean, you would create a folder for that. And this is my process, the way that I think. Anytime that you set something up, it's got to be based on your mentality, your thought process, because if you can't remember, if this doesn't work for you, because time is money, and you need to, if you're spending all your time looking for fonts that are somewhere in your damn computer, it's going to take away from your project time. And project times are everything. You know what I mean? Like, you don't want to spend too much time looking for fonts. So anytime that you add a font to these folders, okay? Since this font folder, the main folder, this external our hard drive, is hooked up to the software main type, it's going to pop up automatically. It's going to update when it opens. You know what I mean? So what I did was I deleted all of the fonts so you could see how it synced up. So if you click here, you're going to go to browse wherever you want your fonts to be. This is my external hard drive. And then I'm going to choose the folder fonts, select folder. Now this is the new Professional Edition 11, the updated version. So it will automatically install all your fonts from the folder after synchronization. So basically what that means is anytime you add a font to the folders on the external hard drive, it will automatically update so you don't have to hit the refresh button now. And then the smart install, it says if a similar font is already installed, it will be uninstalled. So that way you don't have duplicate fonts, you know, bogging up your system. And then you press OK. It will take some time to do that. And then all of your fonts in a group folders will appear here, including the new one that I just added. So it's as simple as that. Now it's going to take a while for, I don't know, the 25,000 fonts to appear here. It's not here, but just know that it's going to be here. And because I'm recording over the screen, it's just going to slow down the system anymore. Just know and trust that it does work and it's going to be there. And to know that it's going to be there, I'm going to be doing a second video about this software, the updates, and what's new in main type 11. So stay tuned for that video. If you have any questions or if I didn't cover something, please leave it in the comments. Thanks so much for watching, guys. And as always, you know, keep creating. Have a great day.